Yeah, baby, another day in the van life. Air fry. Look at this. Look at this tasty little treat. Yeah, I bet you didn't know you can do microwave croissants in an air fryer, and it's actually way, way better. Cook it at a low temperature so it don't burn, and it'll come out in absolute perfection about 10 minutes. It's not as quick as a microwave, but it tastes better. Oh, another glorious day over Laughlin, Nevada. Yes, we are back in Nevada. If that thing wants to expose correctly there. Yep. Back in Nevada, back at this Laughlin parking lot. But we were just here for the night. We're on the way to somewhere else right now. We're reaching out to some other YouTubers and van lifers in the space, seeing where they're at. Might hook up with them, or might end up in some other spots here in Nevada. I'm not sure, but definitely getting out of Laughlin. And I'm going to stop in Vegas and get a shower. Yeah, why not? I'm up to 3 days. Whoa, I couldn't get a shower here last night because the Anytime Fitness here has been closed for a long time. I didn't realize that. I had to go on Google and mark it permanently closed, and somebody else didn't do it already. Yes, that's right. I work for Google now. What a fabulous morning out here. It is so beautiful. I mean, I'm not into the casino life, but this area, this Laughlin area, really is something. Sun comes up over the mountains, sun goes down over the mountains. I mean, come on. That's pretty special. Up, up, we're heading to Perump. Let's go. Still a lot of snow in the mountains up here. Middle of March. You believe that? Anyway, we're gonna meet up with Maddie Van Halen and crew. I think he's solo right now, but he said he was expecting some people. I don't know. He's posting up in Perump for a while, and I'm gonna go say hey. I'm not staying in Perump too long, but I'll probably hang out for the night. I do believe we have found the secret location of the Maddie Wagon. Maddie Van Halen. If you haven't checked out his channel, you should. I'll put a link down below. All right. I'm doing this all wrong here. Man's looking at me like, what are you doing, bro? You are going the wrong way. Whee. That's Maddie Van Halen. Yay! All right. Okay, I think we got a good home for now. Yeah, we're up. We're leaning to the left, I think. Uh-oh. Why is everything out of my van? Did I find a mouse? Nope, I just couldn't figure out what it was with my cot. Every time I get my cot, it would lean to the right or lean to the left. And that's how I realized that I'm a fat boy and I bent one of the legs. But that might actually work out for me. Oh, the beauty of a no build. Yeah, it only takes about 30 minutes to put everything back in. If that, probably not even 30 minutes. Maybe 20. And back to the way it was. Turn the cot around so the broken side is towards the inside of the outside of the van now. That'll probably work for maybe 2 or 3 nights. But there is a Big 5 Sporting Goods here in Perump, which is where I bought that cot at originally. Might be time to get another one. It was only like 80 bucks. Whatever. Chalk it up to the game. I'll get another one. All right. Well, we have left Maddie and the gang behind. Smokey the van was there, and Maddie was there. They're expecting some more people, but yeah, I rolled out. I'm just going to keep going down the road. There's not a whole lot going on right there. They're just hanging out, which is cool. It's great to sit down and just chat with some people, see what's going on with them, but not much to film, not much going on other than some cool mountains to look at. So let's head on down the road and see if we can do something more exciting with our day, because I'm still in that phase where I just want to see everything. I want to get out there, you know. Other van lifers that I hang out with, they're good sitting in places for 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 25 days, whatever. They're good just chilling. Me, I'm still out here exploring and seeing and doing, and I don't know. I'm still in that phase for me. It's still good for me to go out there and just keep it moving, baby. Let's see where we end up. It appears to be a particular arrangement of stars based on the premise that extraterrestrial life may exist. Let's take a look. The Alien Center. And fireworks, of course. Get your aliens and fireworks on at the same time. Area 51, Alien Center. The Alien Cat House Brothel. Oh, okay. I'm definitely not here for that. Wasn't expecting that. UFO crossing. Grab it before all the aliens take it all. All right. Let's delve into the inner depths of the Alien 50, Area 51 Alien Center. Don't forget to record your experience. Okay, looking like a big convenience store. Interesting. Yeah, get your t-shirts and stuff. Looks like they got a restaurant in the back. Yeah, right. Lots of alien t-shirts. Okay. Yeah. All right. Whatever. Not exactly what I expected, but it's all good. Ooh, looks like a good diner back there. They might have some good food. Tempting. Other than that, yep. Zoltar is an alien.
Area 51 and the extraterrestrial highway. I wouldn't do any hitchhiking around here if I were you.
Ooh, they do got frozen yogurt. Smells pretty good up in here. Let's see what's on the menu. I like the menu. It's pretty dope. How hungry am I right now? Get a fresh sandwich. Might be good for later. All right, quick and dirty in the Alien Center. It was cool to see it in there, but their prices. Are you serious? Yeah, they out of this world. Wow. They must be like had an alien abduction. Had something bad happen and they got to pay for it or something because the prices in there were crazy. I was gonna get like a little sandwich from the thing in the back. It was $16 for one little ciabatta, like a little square ciabatta. Hey, nothing against them. I get it. They got the hustle. This is like the only thing out here in the middle of the desert. Nothing else going on. But damn. Stop by, get a couple of photos, hang out, and call it good. Because that was... What? Are you out of your mind? Nah, wasn't happening. Yep, van life, baby. Plans change. I was going to go up 95, but I just don't see anything of interest whatsoever. I think we got to go to California. Back in California again. Let's go. But I have some plans for California. Let's see what happens. Let's go. Let's go. Come on, keep rolling with me, y'all. Rolling back into Death Valley. Yep, also not on the schedule today, but just happens to be the route I need to go to get where I'm going. So why not roll through Death Valley? A few desert blooms out there. Flowers in Death Valley. Doesn't even seem real. That aspect of Death Valley will always remain cool. We're coming from about 3,500 feet down to below sea level on the same road. That is wild to me. Right, we're not going to mess around in Death Valley too much, but we are going to check out one of the little points that I did drive past the last time I was here. It's Zabrinsky Point. Let's do it. A little climbing action, but I'm going to do it. Even in my slippers, it's going to happen. Let's go. All right, you see my man up there? Being a little bold. How'd he get up there? Must have been a good climb. Heading up the hill. Get my exercise in for the day. Whew, pretty busy out here for a Tuesday. It's all good though. Look at those views. Oh yeah. This is a pretty dope spot. That is crazy down there. All kinds of trails snaking around in there too. If you're feeling energetic and want to die a heat stroke, go down there and check it out. All right, Zabrinsky Point, we got it under control now. Checked off one of the things I missed last time I was here. Pretty cool, but it is hot and there's a lot of people. Time to go, y'all. Let's go. Welcome to sea level, but we're still going down. Wait a minute, what? Yeah, we were just at sea level, but we're going down. Something's not right. It's gonna get crazy. Gas, only $6.31 for a gallon of unleaded. No problem. Got Jeep tours down here, visitor center, RV parking. Death Valley is just jamming, baby. I'm wondering what you do when you camp long-term at Death Valley. Like, what do you do? I guess you do probably a lot of hiking. That's probably the big thing out here is to go hike all over the place. So I have my phone set to switch between kilometers and miles per hour automatically, but we're still in the middle of the United States. What's going on? Some reason, as soon as it lost signal, it switched to kilometers here in Death Valley. Strange things happening in Death Valley. Ooh, look at them beautiful wildflowers out here in Death Valley. Nothing should grow here. It's Death Valley. That's beautiful. It's the sea of yellow out there. Pretty amazing. Everybody's stopping and getting pictures. I'm good. I've seen enough wildflowers for a while in the desert. I'm ready to get out of the desert. Let's go. All right. I think we're finally ascending out of Death Valley, but this is really beautiful. The flowers. That's pretty awesome. Keep rolling up the hill, baby. I think we're finally escaping Death Valley. It's a long drive through this park, but plenty to look at. Beautiful scenery. Crazy people driving. I was following a big old, man, a big old Ford Transit conversion van, whatever. But this dude was just riding his brakes all the way down the mountain. Man, such a bad idea. I could smell his brakes like it was on my own vehicle. Like they had to be on fire. That is so dangerous. Oh well, they're still kicking, still living. Probably pushing the limits of the brakes on that vehicle, but hey, up to you. As long as I'm not in front of you. Driving right at those monstrous mountains, snow-covered clouds, beautiful. Just so epic, coming out of Death Valley, about to hit 395, the famous 395, north to south, California. If you haven't been on 395, better add it to your list. Absolutely amazing highway. Goes right, just skirts right along these gorgeous mountains. All kinds of amazing things to see along the way. Hey, maybe we should do that. Driving into these mountains. Yeah, I just want to get on my camera, on my phone camera. Get a little bit closer, but I think it's focusing on the windscreen. Oh well. That looks insane up there. Sierra Nevadas, baby. Sequoia National Forest just on the other side. What a beautiful, beautiful mountain range. 395 right there, running along up north. We're gonna hit that. Keep playing with these mountains a little bit. Make sure we keep an eye on the weather too. But actually the one spot I'm thinking about stopping for the night, they actually have highs in the 60s, only lows in the 40s. So no snow over there. There, I jumped out, got a little footage on my phone for y'all so you can get a better view of these gorgeous Sierra Nevada mountains. Oh my, they are sexy. So sexy. Anyway, let's get on 395 and head north a little bit. Let's do it. Another booming city, Lone Pine. Kind of a cool little country town. First time I got to see it during the daytime. Last time I rode through here, it was dark. It was cold. I didn't have heat, but they had a great parking spot for me, so I couldn't complain. Slept the night here and froze my butt off. It is nice to be coming back through this area with heat in the van, let me tell you. California, man. All through up here, it's been $5 or more a gallon. Ugh, I'm so glad I got some semi-cheap gas out of Nevada. I still got a half tank. That gives me about 200 miles of affordable gas before I have to mess around with California gas. It's what it is. It's all part of the game, baby. Oh, hey, if I asked you guys to hit that like button today, could you do that for me? I'd appreciate it. Leave a comment down below, share the video, even subscribe to the channel. Would be greatly appreciated. Thank you so much. $3.95, it's pretty much what you get. That's it. Bunch of mountains. That's what you're going to be dealing with, $3.95. I know, it's horrible. Nothing to look at, nothing to do. Going to be a boring drive. You kidding me right now? You're gonna love it. $3.95, baby. Get out here. All right, on the hunt for a campsite for the night. Still a little early to be camping, but yeah, that's fine. We'll just start out early tomorrow, fresh and ready. We're at the Zurich train station. There's not much of a train station here anymore. This is cool. It's like a little, just a little random spot to hang out for the night. I don't think it's gonna be a problem. I think it's gonna be anybody tripping if I park here. But look at this wreckage over here. Let's take a look at this. That looks interesting. Just a big lot here. Plenty of room for everybody. Yeah, I think this will work. We got a horrible view of the mountains. It's gonna suck. Okay, what do you guys think about this for a campsite, huh? Terrible view of the mountains. Of course, there's a ton of glass, gun shells, and yeah, whatever. Exactly what you'd expect to see in a spot like this. I'm sure it's a hot area on the weekends to blow up things. Actually, this looks a lot better up here. Yeah, maybe I'll park up here. Yeah, not as much glass down here. There is just glass everywhere. Kind of nasty. And of course, I got the footwear of choice for walking on glass. Absolutely the best. Yeah, I think this will work for tonight. Hopefully no drama out here. Okay, we're up on this platform here, which this used to be a train station. I'm thinking they probably moved livestock. I don't know so much about passengers, but yeah, it looks like the rails are long gone. There's a huge satellite station out there. Monstrous dishes. Whew, the mountains, Sierra Nevada. Oh, yeah. I think this will work for tonight. Pretty dope until someone takes a shot at me or something. And again, these spots are a little bit exposed, but there's not a whole lot around here that isn't exposed. But this looks all right. This is very cool. There's a really nice river right here too. I'll have to show that to you guys later. We have strapped on some more appropriate footwear and we're gonna go explore around this area a little bit. It's kind of cool out here. Might even walk down to the river. Get a little exercise with my fat butt because yeah, the river's like right there. Let's go check it out. Let's go take a walk around here. It's really nice. Just realized I only have 1 minute of footage left on here. Let's switch to the phone. All right, honey, you look cute up in your little spot right there, but yeah, I'm definitely not liking how exposed that is. It's cute. We'll get a couple of Instagram pics from the doors and whatnot, but then we're going to slide probably somewhere over here, a little more discreet and out the way. Yeah, that's going to be a little smarter. Why make ourselves a target for no reason? I hope nobody's going to mess with us tonight, but yeah, why tempt fate? She looks cute. We'll get some photos. And we'll move on. Well, first we gotta go and explore what's over here. There's a lot of rabbits out of here. They've been running around all over the place. If I was really hungry, I'd have an option. And you might be thinking I'm joking. No, I had to kill a rabbit, strip it, clean it, all that stuff in survival school. So I know rabbits good, especially barbecue. Oh yeah, look at this thing. So this is probably some part of like a grain elevator or some kind of grain mixer, maybe. I don't know. I don't know what this thing is. I'm just guessing. But it looks cool. Everything out here has tons of bullet holes in it. But again, I'm not really shocked. You know, what do the kids do out here for fun? Hey, let's go out and shoot that big metal thing in the field. I mean, I would probably be right next to them joining in. Sounds like fun. Trouble with tribbles. If you know what I'm talking about, you can hang with me. It's exactly what it looks like. Trouble with tribbles right there. Let me know down below. Comment if you know what I'm talking about. You're going to have to go way back for that one. Yeah, sorry, youngsters. You will have no idea what I'm talking about. But some of my older watches will definitely be feeling me on this one. Also, no shock. There's a lot of dumping out here. But some of this stuff looks really weird. I don't know what this green stuff is over here, and there's another pile of white stuff over there. Hopefully not radioactive or poisonous since I'm walking right next to it. A lot of abandoned cattle pens out here, so yeah, I'm assuming this whole little thing has something to do with the rail going through here and whatnot, but I can't find any remnants of a rail whatsoever. So if there was a railway here, they're hiding it well. Maybe by train they meant just because they truck them. You know, by many, I don't know, maybe it has something to do with trucking. Maybe it was a trucking train. That might be more realistic. What am I getting myself into? Look at little honey back there. Bye-bye, honey. We're still walking over to this river. Why not? Get my exercise on. I was tempted just to drive over here, but I'm like, nah, come on. Let's get physical. Let's get them steps up. And then just breathtaking. Just the absolute most stunning valley right here. Whew. Yeah, great place to be walking. Got no issues down here, baby. A river runs through it, my friends. Look at this scene. Come on. That is just beautiful. Yes, that was a car going by me at like 900 miles an hour and felt like he had to get close to me for some reason, but whatever. Gonna let that slide. People are people. Anyway, back to the serene and beautiful scene. This is absolutely gorgeous. Guys, I'm telling you, this spot is so random and so beautiful. Insane. I mean, this just looks so cool.
But you know what I can't figure out? Like, this river, like, runs towards the mountains a little bit. Nah, just the angle. I mean, it does come from the mountains. It just happens to go around this little bend here. So that is pretty legit. Oh, the little colors of the grass. Just look at that scene. Look at that. Okay, I'll shut up. Tell me that's not incredible. Yeah, I know. I said I was going to shut up, but I didn't. It's just beautiful. Oh, my. All right. If you're ever out near Zurich, California, stop on through. Tell them the chocolate man in the van sent you. This is crazy out here. What a spot to hang for the night. This will work. Can you imagine if I had not taken that walk? How crazy would that have been? And not got up close and personal with that amazing scene. Can breathe so well out here. I mean, woo! Beautiful. Oh, yeah. Amazing. Love every minute of this. All right, we made it back to Honey. No issues. Nobody stopped and looked at my van funny or came up here or pulled in unnecessarily. So feeling a little bit safe about tonight, but yeah, we're definitely gonna move. You can literally see my van from way, way over there. So that's not good. That's not good, let's move. Yeah, well that wasn't gonna work. As soon as I found a good spot, man, the mosquitoes went crazy. So we're just gonna go up the hill a little bit. There's a bunch of other spots up here. So, so beautiful though. That's all right. I think next spot will still be beautiful too. Well, this spot kind of sucks, but I guess we'll make it work. Whatever. I can only see everything from up here. I mean, this is... man, I had such a good spot down there with the mosquitoes, and here I am up here where I can see everything. Well, that's just not any fun. Whatever.
Oh my God, you gave up Thailand for this? What were you thinking, casino? You must not be too smart.
Come on, look at that. Tell me how ridiculous that looks. So amazing. Got some epic footage, and then it's just doing this right here. I mean, yeah, right on top of the mountains. Man, look at a little jet going by. Just, yeah, that's what I'm looking at. That's my view for tonight. 100% free 99. Come on. Oh, it's so frustrating, but it's part of the game, living in that van. Had that great spot up there on the hill, overlook, everything's beautiful. But of course, for no reason whatsoever, some cars had to drive right in there, get right next to me, slow down, drive out, and leave. Twice that happened in 2 hours. Nothing else up there. You could easily get by my van without getting near it, but they still had to get right next to me. I'm just like... It really sucks because it was such a good spot. It was so cherry. But anyway, I just went up the road another 10, 15 miles to a little town that has available parking. And there is a bunch of van lifers here. So, yeah, feeling comfortable with that. Going to stay here for the night and we'll just move on down the road. I don't understand people, man. I like, what is so interesting about my van that you need to be near it for absolutely no reason whatsoever? If you're up there to camp, I was like, cool, if you're up there to camp, No worries. Go camp. There's a huge area. There's enough room up there for 20 vans, but you don't need to be right next to me. Like, I don't understand that. I'm like, I'm out. Holla. Anyway, that's going to be it for today, guys. Thanks for watching. Jay's Casino, Chocolate Man in a Van, and I'm out. Salute.